The next time you're at the checkout and you hear the beat, think of the fun you could be having on Supermarket Street.
Wagon Wheels for Bigger, the podcast that when it's at the supermarket and hears the beep, thinks that's the carrots I've just bought. yeah, well,
carrots beep. You buy beeping carrots.
No, the carrots when they've put through. I buy bags of carrots that are already barcoded. I don't buy carrots separately, so they're all pre-packaged. Just I'm Mark.
I'm Martin.
That all went wrong, but like I said to you before I started recording, I thought it was funny. Said it probably wouldn't be. It's too late now.
Fine, it's all good.
This week, we are doing Supermarket Sweep, which isn't from the 80s, it's from the early 90s, but does have Del Winton in it.
Mm-hmm.
Is that a saving grace?
I think so. I think it would be easy to make fun of Dale, and I'm sure we will, but he's actually really good at what he does. He's quite a good game show host, and I think he's quite likeable overall, really.
Apart from his face has gone all like melted and weird now.
Now it has, but this will be young day. Dale. This is Dale from like 24 years ago.
Maths fans.
He's a young man here. He's probably about 40 here.
Another near us age.
Having a lovely time.
Actually, in the supermarket.
He must be younger than us here, surely.
Don't say that. Don't ever say that.
I wouldn't like to think.
I've got to look up his age. I'm just going to say that this was recommended or requested by my wife.
Oh, yes. I know her.
I know her too. I've known her for a while. how old is Del Winton?
So he was born in 1955. So he's 61 now. So he was older than us here, thank f**k. Actually, was he?
Yeah. I don't know. God, you said he was.
I can't do maths.
If he's born 1955, in 1985 he'd been 30. So in 1990, no, he's our age.
He's our age.
Oh my God.
But he looks good for it here.
Not nowadays. No, he's all melted. That's our future. Like all melted, like we've looked into the Ark of the Covenant.
But back in 1993, he was youthful. He was as youthful as both of us.
Wow. And, now, your sister had a crush on Del Winton.
She did. She refused to believe any of the scandalous things that people would say
draw,
about him.
Would draw of him, like I did.
Yeah, I'm not sure how real it was. I'm not sure how much of it was just...
I was 14 when I drew that picture, it's fine.
I've only just thought about that now. I wouldn't have been the first thing that came to my mind. I think she really liked him. I don't know whether it was a crush as much as it was just that she thought he was really good. We'll have to ask her. I might get her to listen to this one and just see what her opinion is.
If you are listening, hi.
Hello.
Picture I drew.
Just horrible trauma for everyone involved.
Yeah,
with that picture. But lovely,
bad.
Lovely, youthful Dale Winton. I'm just letting people imagine a worse picture than it actually was.
It was quite innocent in many ways.
Now, do you want to describe the premise of Supermarket Sweep to everybody who's not sure what it is? I don't know if there's an American equivalent, actually.
Probably. What it is you just run around a supermarket like grabbing stuff off shelves. Pretty much.
There you go. Yeah, and answering easy trivia questions about supermarket
fruit
products.
And veg.
So there might be something. Might just say, you know, you'll see a C and a blank and an R and a blank and an O and a blank, and it will say, "What is this fruit vegetable?" And you'll go, "It's a carrot, Dale." And you have to say Dale after every answer, or it's an invalid answer.
It is. Otherwise, he comes down on you with great anger.
He's like, no.
Furious vengeance.
Say it again. Say my name.
Say my name, baby, is what he says. He doesn't say
it. He does. He says it, but they don't film. They cut that out every time.
They do cut that out every time. But he gets very cross if you do not say Dale at the end of a sentence.
He does.
And it was always very funny if he says, "What's your name?" And they go, "Emma Dale." And then it'd be like the show.
Oh, here we go. Supermarket Sweep is an American television game show.
That's nice. False. British. It's got Dale Winton in it.
False. The format combined an ordinary team-based quiz show with the novel concept of a live timed race through a supermarket, and that dates back to 1965, apparently, so we were well behind the times with Dale.
We were.
Dale.
So, but they don't call them supermarkets in America, do they? Don't they? Do they? I lost that sentence halfway through.
I guess so. They did in the 60s, at least.
I thought they were kind of, I don't
supermarket.
Know, hypermarkets, or...
Just better. Just what's a better word than super?
Super duper hyper markets?
I don't know.
The Shears markets.
Supermarket is surely...
I don't know, it's always a British thing.
If you're American, tweet us. What do you call a supermarket?
And also, tweet us, why did you vote for Trump, you idiots?
What the f*** is wrong with you?
He's an idiot. He's suing sued a 17-year-old girl trying to... for a website she put up of just kittens bopping him in the face. That, he has time to be litigious about a stupid website when he's supposed to be running the free world. I hate him, he's an idiot.
I'd rather not think about that, it makes me sad.
Trump, if you're listening, come at me.
He is one of our listeners. I think he might have suggested what on f***ing earth. So I hate him even more.
What on f***ing earth were people thinking when they voted for him?
What do you think Dale Winton's middle name is?
Gale.
Showbiz. No, it's Jonathan.
That's boring.
Not as good as my answer. Shall we watch Dale Winton Supermarket Sweep 1993 General Ep 1 uploaded by Whammy Rules?
Whammy does rule. If it'd been Whammy, is it Whammy Rules with a Z or with an S?
Just an S. It's not extreme.
That is not extreme enough for my liking.
Doesn't rule to the max. It just rules.
To the min. Yes, let's watch Supermarket Sweep. Okay, so 3, 2, 1, check it out. I actually missed the button then, but never mind.
Might have to look up the American version just to see if the music's the same and everything as well now.
Check it out. This is the most depressing looking supermarket I've ever seen.
It's a really sad little... in reality, it would be like a Netto or a Budgeons, wouldn't it?
Yeah, it's not a supermarket at all.
Not really. It's almost like it's what you'd find now at a petrol station.
Yeah.
Almost. Just a little bit bigger.
Crack addicts. Buying soup.
Used to really hate the voiceover guy because, like, when he's narrating the race at the end, he's always just, like, falling apart laughing. And I've realised now, 103 episodes into our podcast, that I hate him because I see myself in that. Because all I do is talk over stuff and laugh.
You do. You ruin this podcast. It's so much better without you.
I do.
If it's just me, this would be the best thing ever.
Bluff.
I don't mean that. I don't mean that. I kind of mean it. I don't.
Oh, look, they're wacky. He came out like we're doing the secret signal from Team America. There, that guy.
Oh, hilarious. I really want some of them to fall over. Oh my god, it's double Deirdre. Am I seeing double four Deirdres?
That guy claps like a teacher.
What a horrible jacket and shirt. And why are his trousers so high?
Look how young he looks. That makes me feel better. He's the first person we've seen that's about our age that actually looks about right.
He does.
Thank you, Dale.
That makes me feel better. Thanks, Dale. The Dale. It doesn't work. Oh, that does make me feel really... Not good about myself. I'm never that. but better. A bit.
I'm not eyeing up the razor blades tonight.
Nope.
Oh, God. This is actually... It just makes me think of, like, when I was skiving off school and I would just
or
watch
college.
This.
Or university.
Yeah. Or college. Or work.
Whereas now, it's just not the same.
No. There's nothing good anymore on telly.
That's a lie, actually, because with Challenge TV, actually, it's just all day. This. Stuff like this. Do you look how they've written Super Savers in the background? Like soup.
Well, they spelt it wrong. Oh, no, I see, yeah.
It's clever.
Clever.
I had a shirt like that. In fact, I think I've still got a shirt like that.
What, the black and white guy?
Yeah, the lumberjack one.
It's a really puffy one, though. He looks like he's just come from the Crystal Maze, and he's taken off his gilet, and now he's ready to run around a supermarket.
Oh, these clueless idiots running around a supermarket. That's... They just stand in the middle aisle, just blankly looking around.
What's he looking for? What was the quiz clue?
I don't know. I wasn't listening. But it's obviously something to do with juice, is it?
Juice. Try looking. Juice. Get the juice.
Move things, idiot. I can't see the juice for the juice. Is it juice? Again, this is a bit out of focus, like the last two episodes have been.
There was a really enthusiastic person in the audience shouting the countdown then. 3, 2, 1!
You cretin. Where's he going now?
He's looking. Come here, Dale. You can't even find Dale.
You'll be punished, malnutrition chuckle brother.
Steve.
Oh, I was in the fresh orange juice. Oh, you idiot, Jared. Is that what he said?
What I liked there was that Dale didn't even make eye contact with Steve while he just pushed him away to go back to his partner.
Don't touch me.
Jenny and Susan. Do you like their shopping trolley stickers they've got their names written on?
Ah, oh, do you know, I've never even noticed they were shopping trolley stickers.
I don't think I'd put any thought into it till now.
Do you remember? Right, now, Susan has a haircut like
Princess Richie,
like Richie Rich in Filthy Rich and Cat Flap.
I suppose she does.
Which is an awful haircut.
Yeah.
May Rick Mail rest in peace, comedy legend.
Yeah.
Steve. Oh, no, he's Jared. He's Steve. I got the names confused.
Yeah, they were talking about Jared. But it was behind his back. Thinking of Steve.
He's thinking of Steve, talking to Jared.
Do you think that's fresh produce behind Dale, or do you think it's plastic?
I think it's fresh.
Exciting.
Although they need to replenish some of the melons. It's quite. I don't know where the shelf stackers are, but they're not doing their job properly.
Because if it's fresh fruit, like, it must get all bruised later on when they're banging it about all over the place.
You think, wouldn't you? But then, if they've got any common sense, they won't bother putting fruit and veg into their trolley because it's just not going to be worth anything.
It's mostly inflatables you're looking for in supermarket sweep.
And his shopping list.
And start taking the role of someone who works in the supermarket by pricing up some beans and then putting them in your trolley.
Yeah. It's when they're kind of like filling up with like tins. Tins are cheap, you idiots.
Go to the videos.
You want to get bleach and Persil. Then drink it, you idiots. So now we've got Double Deirdre on here.
Double Deirdre. I'm rooting for Double Deirdre now.
Double Deirdre.
They've brought a mascot. Like, they think they're on Blockbusters.
Well, it's almost that level of complexity, isn't it?
It is.
I just realised that was their buzzer. I thought there was a jar of Marmite on their counter.
See, they should have done that. They should have themed the buzzers like tins and jars.
And then put an electric charge through them.
Yes, definitely.
Not to make the sound, to...
To electrocute them.
To electrocute them viciously. Now...
Having a lovely time.
Are they sisters?
I don't know.
Or do they just really weird and they just dress exactly like each other? And same haircut, same glasses.
Hair and face.
Where do they go? Where do the others have to... Where do they go?
They're literally just off camera, probably.
Dale's a good-looking man, actually. I can see why your sister would have a thing for him.
He's a good-looking man.
I take that picture back.
She was in denial.
I remember exactly what that picture looked like. I could draw it now.
I think you should draw it now and then tweet it when this goes out.
That was slightly off screen. I remember that off the page. It was on a lead. And he was holding the lead.
And when you've drawn it, can you send it over to me through like WhatsApp or something? Because I can't really remember.
I've drawn it quite badly. I've given him a perm. He hasn't got a perm.
No, he's got like quite a nice quiff.
The general theme. I'm drawing it in a kind of daring, wearing
sausage
kind of way.
Bill Tidy.
Bill Tidy way. My friend Daring Wearing has a problem.
It was sausage.
Multiple
I said sausage
sclerosis.
Straight away.
That would have been a real problem for Daring Wearing. If he'd been diagnosed with MS.
I'm trying to find a copy of Bill Tidy's Let's Draw book, which I'm sure has got some Daring Wearing stuff in it.
Didn't I buy that for you one year? I definitely got you something Daring Wearing. I'm sure I did. Something by Bill Tidy.
I don't recall. I mean, I've been looking
sure
for it for
I
you,
did.
So...
I'm so sure that I did.
I don't.
Unless I dreamt at the same time I was dreaming that Max Headroom was making a comeback. Because my dreams have been really dull lately.
It is the kind of thing you would dream.
It is. And I wake up all excited thinking of a Bill Tidy book. Is it here? Oh, disappointed. It was all a dream.
Or was it?
Yes, it was.
So, boring questions about supermarket produce.
Oh, yeah, back to this.
And his little finger's all twisted and weird.
Is it? Who? Dale's?
Dale's, yeah. He was holding that card and his little finger was all, like, curled up. It's gone back to normal now.
Thought it had, like, a Dave Allen thing going on.
No.
Not that exciting. Let's see, just tell him if he's right. Let's see if you're right. I've got the answers here.
I don't want to anger you. If a noise tells you you're wrong, it's not my fault.
I'm Dale Winton.
Which city am I in?
London, I assume.
Chips and mayonnaise, bridges.
That's right. Dale was shocked then he'd get that right in his kind of weird colour. Actually, his suit kind of matches that guy's t-shirt.
Which city am I in? I'm smoking drugs and getting fellatio from a lady. In a shop window.
In a shop
Birmingham.
Window. In the window of Curry's.
That's right, I'm in Bristol.
I just want to get to the bit where they run around the shop.
Yeah, that's the best bit. That's all anybody cares about.
This is boring. I don't know why they bothered with this.
Oh, a duck sound. Exciting.
You know what? I would love to do a genuine supermarket sweep, though.
Like, I think that was the appeal of this.
I just go straight to the electrical section.
Well, yeah. I bet they have, though, like, limits when you actually have that kind of...
Yeah, you're not allowed in the electrical section.
No. More than three of one item or something.
I've got three of your TVs, idiots. All your tablets. Boom. In your face, Billy Sainsbury's, whatever your name is.
That's from something that we did as well, or we were planning on doing at some point.
Was it weird rivalry? Billy Tesco and little Jimmy Sainsbury's? Something like that,
yeah. It wasn't really fully thought through, was it?
No, it was just that.
It's just words. Those words.
Right, so these are some well-known brands of detergent.
Ultra.
They have to guess the prices.
Yeah, that's something to do with prices, isn't it? Or which one's the most expensive?
Which one's less than a pound? Fabric conditioner? Washing up liquid? Or lemon liquid cleaner? I'm glad he specified it was lemon liquid, because that lemon will make a difference. I think it's the washing up liquid. It's cheaper than the pound.
I would have thought so in 1993.
I think so. Jared's gone for number two, like me. Good man.
She might as well just go for three now.
Single Deirdre went for two as well.
She's ruined that for me now.
129. You're wrong.
Oh no.
It was a lemon liquid cleaner.
The lemon liquid cleaner. Oh. That looks quite expensive for 24 years ago.
It does. Screw you, Dale. Your supermarket's prices are out of whack.
I'll just go to Poundland.
Everyone goes to Poundland now for stuff like that. Well, I don't.
Yeah.
Not bother. It's in the middle of town. It's a hassle.
For brand name crisps and chocolate, you can't go wrong with Poundland. Poundland.
I thought this was your slogan for brand name crisps and chocolate, you can't go wrong with Poundland.
I was hoping that they might use that as an advert and pay me, but now I realise I've just done it for free, so they probably won't.
Just that soundbite. Exactly, yeah. as you did it.
Yeah. That's all they're getting out of me. for a pound.
Oh, anagram round. What the hell?
Gralanidage.
Gralanged. Darjeeling. Ooh,
she's clever.
If I'd heard what the food product was, I would have got that.
Nice. All right, well, I'll be quiet this time. And you can...
Dry French.
French.
Garlic.
Sausage.
No,
it's not that.
Not really. Garlic. Garlic? What the hell is that? Garlic.
Granules. Actually, it could be.
I think
that.
It is garlic granules. Why is it a duck? What's a duck got to do with a supermarket for the sound? Well, we've run out of time. We'll have a duck noise for no reason. They should have like a clocking off whistle.
It's friendly, isn't it? South American.
Coffee.
Colombian coffee.
Colombian
well
coffee.
Done.
Got the coffee Gone bit. The easy Jenny. Bit.
Oh, he's so pleased with himself there, isn't he?
It's like he made them up. Spray. Starch spray.
Oh. Starch spray.
In your face, people from the past. I got there first. Idiots.
She's doing well. She's got 1 minute 40 on her clock.
We're getting into
last
this.
Chance.
This is good.
This is pubs, coloured, breadcrumbs, fried seafood.
That's, I can't see what that is.
No. Dongle.
Aspic.
Mipsack.
Golden scampi.
Oh yeah.
That is a thing.
It's more a thing than Mipsack, like what I said.
Aspic is a thing. That's what I said. Aspic.
Yeah, they appear too quickly to not just be right next to them.
Yeah, I think they should just duck down. If they're not answering your question.
Yeah, just sit on the floor cross-legged like they're in school assembly.
Sit on the floor. And sing when a night one is Spurs.
All right, so here we go, the round robin.
What's that mean? What's happening now? Where am I?
It's the round where they all think about Robin from Batman and Robin.
Or Robin from...
Robin's Nest.
That's it, thank you. Or Robin Cook.
Round Robin, I think, just means take it in turns.
So why don't they just call it
the take it in turns round? Oh, Steve, you did get it right, but we all thought you didn't for a second.
Oh, Steve, you're such a card. But change those last two letters for three letters.
I was laughing at a word you didn't say before.
But I implied it.
Yeah. Which country
does Chianti wine come from? What did you say, Sweden?
Just shrugged as well. If you don't know, Steve, don't buzz in and ruin it for everybody else.
Oh, you ruined it for Jared.
Jared doesn't want to wear pink. You know, you've got to really try.
Is that going to be their coloured jumper?
Well, it depends on who goes first, second, and third, doesn't it?
Oh,
I can't remember which colour is which. Yeah, it's like a pastel pink, yellow, and blue. But
I never realised there was an order. I just assumed they were just, you know, given colours.
No, I'm pretty sure. He's just guessing and getting it right. He's an idiot savant.
Was the question, name a fruit? An apple.
Question was, what is the first thing that what on earth turns into in what on earth?
A prick.
A paedophile? Correct.
Paedophile apple. Pedo apple. Apple file. That'd be something else, wouldn't it? I don't like apples much. They're quite boring, aren't they, as a fruit?
It depends on it, really, which one they are. Lots of different apples.
What, like toffee apple?
Apple turnover, that's all right.
The problem with the toffee apple is they've taken something good and they've ruined it by shoving an apple in it and a stick up it.
Yeah.
Just give me toffee on a stick. Just give me toffee. Actually, don't give me toffee. Give me chocolate. Give me a chocolate apple, but without the apple. And the stick. Just pour it into my hands.
Look at the size of that tie he's wearing as well.
Look at his jacket.
It's really wide.
Steve put his hand right up then. Who's going
first?
For
a second, I just thought he was Nazi saluting. It just came up so quick.
I accidentally did that the other day. I was waving someone and realised it was more like a Nazi salute. I just kept my hand quite still.
That is a Nazi salute.
Yeah, then I apologised and said, sorry, that was not intentional.
Drew attention to it, I imagine.
And yes, I did draw attention to it. It probably just looked like a wave to everyone else, but to me, I became very self-conscious.
Did you sort of click your heels together and straighten your back while you did it?
I just went, blur.
Yeah, see, one is pink, two is blue, three is yellow. That's the rules.
I like that two and blue rhyme. That was probably intentional.
That's probably why they did that.
Three and yelly.
So, you can get extra points if you get all the items on Dale's shopping list, which are as follows. Bunch of bananas. That's right.
Three jar of malt. Of lube. No, that's it.
No, he's using a tin of black treacle in this episode and multivitamins.
That'd be really uncomfortable.
And if you get a big inflatable, just like you say at all supermarkets, then that'll be worth some money as well.
That's the only place I buy my inflatables.
you just find them and just they give you money at the till. He's doing a weird salute there. Yeah. It was a flag wave.
Oh, look at those stripy trousers. I don't dislike them. So he's got a bunch of problems. Just take the trolley. This annoys me when they don't take the trolley.
I'll go and do the shopping list and waste half a minute.
They took the trolley as well, that she could be putting crap into. He's done it as well.
Look at him run.
He runs like a right div.
I really wanted him to knock all of that over then.
It'd be funny if he just deliberately just ran into it.
Because they get a penalty, don't they, if they knock stuff on the floor and don't pick it up. Yeah, pretty sure.
Why are they used to in the later ones. They could be
ironing board.
Idiots. This is annoying me.
Get three ironing boards, Steve.
You're allowed three. That's right. Just take one tin at a time. Run back. That's it. Take the trolley.
He runs like Tom Cruise, you know, like blades hands, just like
or like the T-1000.
Yes, yeah.
Why is Steve is not picking things up? Take your trolley, you stupid Deirdre.
She's lost.
What is she doing?
She's filling in the shopping list now. But it just always struck me as such a waste, because if you just went and like emptied the shelves, you'd probably get more than if you went for the shopping list bonus.
What? It's when they're actually like perusing the shelves as well. Just chuck stuff in.
What's the best bin? Just f***ing grab three!
You're allowed three. That's the rules, Steve.
I'm sure that's the rules.
It is the rules.
Get barbecue briquettes. That'll probably be expensive.
What's she picking up?
Towels. Towels are expensive.
Towels are expensive. Oil. Petrol oil. Petrol oil? Diesel oil.
Kettles and flasks. Come on.
He doesn't know whether he's coming or going.
Oh, he's coming. Oh, no. This is taking a horrible turn.
What's she chucking in?
They're all ignoring the videos.
Ready meals. Ready meals are cheap.
In 1993, a video was worth about $15.99.
It was. They're all idiots.
Not now, though.
They're the stupidest people on earth.
I hate them all.
Oh, they didn't do wonderfully, Dad. Don't sugarcoat it.
Why does Jared look out of breath when he just stood there and watched?
What is the point of the other person just standing there as well?
This is funky, this music, though.
There you go, all smiling at the camera. I'm smiling to the camera. I'm not a model. This is my actual job. I am paid minimum wage for this. This is exciting now. We're going to find out what the inflatables are worth.
That is always the best bit, isn't it?
Oh, that's exciting.
Oh, they double Deirdre's, didn't even get one.
They got £100, though, for the
shopping list.
That's right, applaud them. Applaud
their
stupidity.
Maybe the shopping list is worth doing.
£103.
That would always annoy me, though, because that would sometimes happen, that you'd get the bonus, and then they'd be, like, £10 more.
Yeah. £100. What's your Brucey bonus?
Look at those bruised bananas.
Rubbish. You went for the wrong inflatable, Steve, and he does look disappointed by that.
He's really f***ed off, isn't he?
It'd be funny if he just looked around and just booted it. It's just cheating.
£271.
Well, they've got one. Disappointing. I take it back. I assume the Deirdre's had done badly.
What did the Deirdre's get?
Idiots.
Just breaking the fucking inflatables now.
And Steve just grabs that one and boots that one. The bananas.
What did the Deirdre's get?
286.
Oh, they did do well. With no inflatable.
Come on, Deirdre's. We're rooting for you.
Good shoppers, double Deirdre's.
Come on, double Deirdre. Double Deirdre delight.
And
boom.
They went last. They had the least time.
They did. I take it back. I said they didn't shop sensibly, but they did. They shopped
good shoppers. They didn't piss around looking for inflatable bollocks. That's why.
No.
Now you must go. Let's take the shopping to needy families.
Yeah, you don't keep that.
Put it back on the shelves.
Double Deirdre's. Well, yeah, they're probably filming another episode straight after this, aren't they?
I expect so.
That is how they tend to do it, I believe.
I'm looking at some of the signs in the background. We sell petrol, one of them says. We now sell petrol.
Oh, yeah,
look behind Deirdre's head. Big discounts always.
In bottles in the aisles is how they sell petrol.
We now sell petrol in Coke cans. Good luck.
When you're eating bread and cheese, sweet Plowman something is sure to make a better sandwich. Plowman's relish. Pickle. So pickle. Same.
Oh, wouldn't that be better if there was a rhyme?
Yeah.
Pickle here!
Found it! Right, the next clue.
Go for it.
It's not a plum, it's not a peach, it tastes a little bit of each. A fruit that's really in between. We're thinking of a nectarine.
We're thinking of a bunch of bananas.
I would not have got that.
No, but you'd have gone looking for the plums.
A wedding cake to celebrate, you've married Mr. Wright, and something sugar makes the top so smooth and snowy white. Icing sugar.
Icing sugar? God, she's manic.
She is. They got it.
Fuck off!
They found it, and the alarms went off, and now the security's coming.
Just stop beating them.
You can't take that off the shelf, love. You've got to pay for it.
Just run out of the shop with it.
That money is technically lost property, and you are now a criminal.
How much should they win, anyway?
I think that's £1,000.
What a waste of time.
It's the biggest small amount that is, like, acceptable on a daytime quiz show, isn't it?
What a hassle for £1,000.
They got to be on this.
Strike it lucky.
But sort of bother. At least on Supermarket Sweep, you got to meet Dale Winton.
That is true. Whereas,
that said,
on
that Supermarket
lucky.
Was. you got to
live
in Manhattan. Not always. That said, the supermarket was stocked by Asda, apparently, so it would have been Asda brand stuff and maybe some of their signage.
That Asda be why it was so good.
Next time you're at Asda and you see the "we now sell petrol" sign, think of the fun you could be having in Supermarket Sweep.
Yeah, it's all in their pick and mix.
You've got to find it. That's the Supermarket Sweep element. That was quite good. I'm really glad that that your good lady wife suggested we watch that.
Yeah, I'm quite pleased as well, actually. I enjoyed it.
A very nice episode and a very pleasing age discovery for young Dale as well. Oh god, in 24 years we'll have melty faces. Who am I kidding? I'll be dead.
Yeah, you will.
But if you can think of any other game shows you'd like us to watch, I don't care really, it's all right, isn't it? If you can think of any other game shows you'd like us to watch, then let us know, you idiots. You can email us if you like wagonwheels@outlook.com, or you can do the other things that Mark will say now.
Actually, I just found some interesting facts about Supermarket Sweep.
All right, well, let's do that then, because that's more fun.
Sorry, I should have said before we started doing the...
Sorry, I was, yeah.
The ending bit.
Keen to wind up, but I shouldn't be. Let's go.
Okay, so number one, the meat was fake.
Aw.
These aren't funny.
Okay.
Number two, a lot of the food was expired.
Ooh. Yeah. Well, those bananas definitely looked a bit bad that they did. That Steve and Jared were manhandling.
Winners didn't get to keep the food.
Well, yeah, that's obvious by the sort of models in the background stealing it away as quickly as possible. Yeah.
Beauty products could win you the game. Heading for the beauty aisle instead of the meat freezer could very well have won you the game.
What, if you wore the beauty products?
Okay. No, if you supermarket swept them.
If a nice lady dressed up for Dale and said, "Look how pretty I look," then his head would turn.
Oh, apparently it says, winning during the taping didn't guarantee you'd actually collect your winnings.
How does that work?
I don't know.
You can't give me half a fact.
I know, I don't understand that.
Did it depend if Dale liked
you or
not?
Apparently contestants got to map out their routes. They didn't get to map out their routes. That must have come later.
Must have been.
The supermarket was really, really small. Well, we knew that. Well, that was boring. What a waste of time. Follow us on YouTube and iTunes. Sorry about that.
And Twitter at Spread the Whimsy. Facebook.com/WhenWagonWheels were bigger.
All of that.
YouTube, When Wagon Wheels were bigger.
iTunes, When Wagon Wheels were bigger.
So all those things, really.
All of them.
And that's a shame we're ending on a down note, but it is what it is. Bye.
Bye.
For brand name crisps and chocolate, you can't go wrong with Poundland. Poundland. Sponsor us?